makes a quick, frugal, easy, delicious strawberry shortcake. Yeah. All right, this is one of my favorite foods. We're making strawberry shortcake with homemade biscuits. You don't make your strawberry shortcake with those store-bought dessert shell cake dealy boppers. No, that's gross, that's fake. That's like making strawberry shortcake with a Twinkie. You don't do that. You are baking biscuits from scratch. This is what we're gonna do. We start with 2 cups of flour in our bowl. But first, let's talk buttermilk, because we want to make buttermilk biscuits. But Frugal Amy is not going to go spend money on buttermilk. So we're going to take our regular milk, and we're going to put a tiny little bit of vinegar in it, and that's going to like make it all curdly and buttermilk-ish. In here, we have about a half a cup of milk. The drip on the floor. Now let's see if I can do this without pouring the whole jug of vinegar all over the floor. I think I did it. So we put the milk aside for a second to do its vinegary magic, and we'll go back to the flour. To the flour, we are going to add 3 tablespoons of baking powder. Now, you know, I don't believe in food expiring, per se, but your baking powder and your yeast will expire and they will stop making things rise. So you want to make sure your baking powder has not too old. And that's 1, 2, and the rest of it is 3 tablespoons of baking powder. Salt and about 3/4 teaspoon of salt. Your final dry ingredient is 1 tablespoon of sugar. Sugar. Yeah. That'll stir around. Normally I use shortening. Inexpensive shortening that I got from Aldi. But I don't have any right now. So I'm actually going to use butter. Real butter. Butter goes on sale at Christmas time, and that is when I stock up on 30 or 40 pounds of butter at $2 a pound and freeze it. We're going to start by cutting in about 1/2 cup of cold butter, and we're going to mix it into the flour with our fingers. You can use a fork if you want or a pastry cutter, but I like to use my fingers. Take your little hands and you work your butter into your dry ingredients until you have your classic little crumbly butter flour combo top deal. Did you see that come out all lumpy and curly looking? That's what we're going for. Now we stir in the milk. Now you can bake this as drop biscuits, where you just take a spoonful of dough and flop it on your cookie sheet and bake it like that. Or you can roll it out and cut nice, round, perfect little biscuit shapes, which I don't usually bother to do. But I'm going to do it today for you, so you can see how fun that is. Now a lot of normal people would use a rolling pin to roll out their dough, and then they have like a nice little round biscuit cutter. But I do have a rolling pin somewhere. All I have to do is use a big old drinking glass, and I use this to roll out the dough, and then I cut my biscuits with the round. You put your cutout biscuits on your baking sheet, which I have lined with parchment paper, which I got couponing, because to me parchment paper is an enormous luxury that we don't go out just paying for willy-nilly. Now the biscuits are going into our 350 degree oven, and we will move on to the strawberry preparation. Are strawberries a frugal ingredient? My buy price for strawberries is $2 a pound or less. So when they're in season and I can get them for $2 a pound or less, I get them, I stock up, we eat them, yum, we freeze some, yay. Now, What's critical to your strawberries for your strawberry shortcake is that you have some juice, because you want some moisture when you're putting your strawberries over your warm, delicious buttered biscuit. So what you do ahead of time is you freeze yourself some strawberries, and then you thaw them out, and when they're thawed out, then they get all juicy. Okay, now we have our fresh strawberries combined with our thawed out frozen strawberries, and you want to give it a taste to see how sweet it is. If it's a little bit sour, you can add a little sprinkling of sugar if you want to bring out the sweetness. I'm probably not going to do that because mine are sweet. This is going to go on top of our biscuits. Alrighty, I just pulled my biscuits out of the oven. They baked for half an hour. These are big biscuits. Normally they bake for maybe more like 25 minutes if they were normal sized biscuits. That is a big, hot, beautiful biscuit. So how we put the shortcake together? Put your big old biscuit in a bowl. If you want, you can split it open, butter it, or just plop it in like that, put some butter on the top. You want to make sure it's warmed up. This one is hot right now. Then you pour your strawberries over your hot buttered biscuit, and you top it with, you know what I'm going to say, your Cool Whip, your Cool Whip. You top it with your Cool Whip. 50 cents with couponing. And of course you can use real whipped cream if that is your druthers. Okay, we've put our strawberry shortcakes together. We have the biscuit in the bottom of the bowl warmed up. We have the strawberries poured on top and the Cool Whip. And here we have our taste testers, Meaty and Autumn. All right, everybody, let's give it a taste and see what we think. And you can't just eat the Cool Whip off the top. I think most normal people would eat this for dessert. We're having it for breakfast. All right, Autumn, what do you think?
Delicious.
And Neve, what do you think of your strawberry shortcake?
Amazing.
Amazing! And again, to reiterate Autumn's response, I believe that was?
Delicious.
Delicious. Okay, so thanks for joining us for another fun, fabulous, frugal cooking extravaganza. This is frugal. This is delicious. This is homemade. This is amazing. You can do it.